Hello, welcome back to Kaiserreich. I'm vibing to this music. Oh no, it's ending just as I say that. Oh, never mind, it's still there. Okay, so we gotta pick a head of the Air Force, and also apologies if my voice is a bit shitty, but this is recorded on a Sunday, I believe. Sunday, right? Yes, it's a Sunday. It's being recorded on a Sunday, which means it is the day after Saturday, which is often the day associated with the national Norwegian pastime of binge drinking. Anyways, let's see, we should go for Eddie August Schneider, just because I think he has a bunch of really good, let's say international, yeah. A bunch of really good modifiers, but Berta Costa is also a valid choice simply because the Ace Generation chance is actually very, very good. That bonus is actually huge because it means you get a bunch more aces, and those aces then give even more bonuses to your air wings. So that is often like the best bonus to go for, but it only gives us paratrooper stuff, which, I mean, we are not going to use that in the near future. However, we are going to need air superiority. But yeah, I see interception and stuff. Air superiority defense is good. There's general air superiority there as well, which is also good. I'll go with that one. The goal in all air battles is air superiority. Once you have that, you can then, you know, think of what to do next. But before that, like, you... There's nothing really. But yeah, the war has begun. And... we gotta get going. Let's see here. We also... let's see, push on the... Federal Front, which grants attack bonus against the country. Ah, cool, so you can announce a push, but we need command power and political power for that, so we can't do that yet. However, we could... okay, we're still recruiting militia in Pennsylvania. The next militia we should recruit is in New York City. Which will probably give us the troops we need to push north. Apparently they don't seem to have a lot of troops in the north. They're actually taking New York City, we can't allow that. I'll try to encircle them, take Albany and stuff, and I'll send maybe one division up there. The Red Guard. The rest I'll have pushed down south and try to meet the longest border. The longest, not longest. Actually, no, we can use the Illinois militia to take the north here. Orders. Who's leading them? It's Oliver Law. Okay, cool. Oh, this is a far too somber song for this kind of situation. I haven't heard Two Good Men. Hopefully it fits. Well, let's see, the garrison here, the militia reserves. Oh, that's a fucking motorized. That's gonna be a pain in the ass. And these guys, St. Louis. Okay, so we might wanna go down a bit. With these guys. Actually, no, we'll keep them here so they can potentially respond to a push on Chicago. Oh, it's this song. We got a lot of military factories all of a sudden, so we gotta start this gun production. That many artillery gun artillery guns actually works. Should be enough. That many big guns, rather, is a better way of phrasing it. We shouldn't need too many motorized cars, so we should probably be able to get by with only two there. However, this leaves a lot of industry for us. So I'm actually gonna ramp this up. Fucking absurd levels, and then I'm going to create another line at the bottom and then pump the rest of the factories into that, because then these guys get the focus for production, like they get the resources and the factories, while the bottom one is basically going to handle any overflow that we have and push that into guns. In fact, actually, I can reduce this and then let that still be the overflow. Let's put everyone under the same... it's just called Syndicalist. Syndicalist... what do you call this? Syndicalist Revolutionary Army? Syndicalist Militia? Syndicalist Army? I don't know. Syndicate Army? I don't know. Yeah, Revolutionary Red Guard, Revolutionary Mobile Corps, Illinois Militia, and the Militia Reserves. We need rubber, which we could get from Germany's Asia, but we're not gonna do that because they are in the middle of a civil war with our enemy. Oh, sorry, our allies, technically, by ideology, our the people we should have solidarity with. So we should probably trade with them instead. And then for the tungsten, I'm kind of upset that it doesn't line up perfectly here. The tungsten, we should buy from the Baratia Commune. Sorry if you could hear that chair squeak there. I do need to fix this chair. Probably gonna get a new one next semester when I possibly move. Alright, cool. We're fighting here now. I should probably just activate these guys. Send them down. We gotta take Washington. The final act of the Second Internationale Congress. With all important decisions made during the first week, the Congress has moved on to less pressing matters. After 10 days of negotiations, discussion, and politicking, the delegates came up with one final act, a declaration of eternal brotherhood and readiness to face the imperialists wherever they are to be found. Cool. And we get volunteers. Of course we'll take them. We're not actually getting the imported oil, or sorry, rubber from Indochina. Let's get some from Brazil then, it's closer. Oh, no, yeah. Commune of France doesn't have enough to give us. I'm not gonna push here because that's just gonna create a... Oh! Syndicalist revolutionaries in Switzerland. Chaotic reports are coming from the small mountain Republic of Switzerland, stating that syndicalist revolutionaries have seized the western regions of the Romandie and occupied Haute Savoie, following a Swiss military crackdown in the region. Supporting the successful Swiss revolutionaries, French troops have quickly moved in to occupy the region, and the Swiss military has held a defensive posture, unwilling to advance into the French guns. It seems that the speed of the revolutionary action has caught the Swiss government off guard, and they are unwilling to escalate the violence into a full war with France. It remains to be seen what the Swiss will do next. So this is one of those flashpoints, those crises, that Germany and France could end up at war over. There's a number of those, and I find them very interesting, very interesting turning points. Actually, I need to actually set up an attack plan. There we go. Push them all north. National focus. What do we have to take between here? So we've got the Second Continental Army. Now we can do a gun in hand, infantry tech, or we can do uniforms and grenades. That's support infantry equipment, I believe, or like infantry weapons and equipment. I'll go with infantry equipment, I think, because this gives defense breakthrough, and this one gives soft attack, and... Yeah, it just gives soft attack. I'll give, Oh, cool, they want to give us, guns. We actually need, We need a fuck ton of convoys, then. Yeah, let's go with, actually, a Smedley Butler or Political Officers are the paths here. So that one requires uniforms and grenades, gives us mobilization speed, and this one requires, we don't need mobilization speed right now. And this one gives us some training for Smedley Butler. Yeah, that means, that one is actually the best one, because that's going to apply to all of our troops, because he's the commander-in-chief. Even though Oliver Law is technically our chief of staff. This song is perfect. Three emergency reserve units will be raised in the capital. Okay, so that's is not in full control of Illinois. That's okay, so that we can do that one as an emergency. Let's see, look at Illinois. Yep, we've lost pieces of it, in which case, yes, let us do that. Call up the emergency reserves. Put them in the militia reserves, and then strengthen the line here. Focus on holding the important cities and stuff. We can lose some farmland and such. Now, okay, even more guns. And even more guns. Tsardom has been restored in Russia. Under Tsar Kirill I. Alright, well, we got more pressing matters to attend to. I'm sorry if I can't read all of those right now, because then the episode would be all of me reading, you know, technically Wikipedia entries, which episodes 1 through 5 of the US playthrough are still there if you want to watch them. That one was a lot of, like, events and stuff. Oh, cool, we got an encirclement as well. Directive 10, redistribution of material assets. Oh boy. Now that the revolution has begun, we must decide what should be done to the bourgeoisie. The IWW proclaim, we confiscate all their wealth and redistribute it to the people immediately. The up-and-coming vanguard has called for their immediate arrest and execution as well. What the fuck? Citing the fate of Vladimir Lenin as an example of a revolution defeated by leniency. The SPA members belong to the depreciated AFL, along with several loyal progressives, have sought... What? The SPA members belonging to the depreciated AFL, along with several loyal progressives, have sought life over death, asking the central committees to only expropriate what is necessary for war and keep the materialist constituents happy. So either their wealth and lives are ours, or we may need these moderates in the future. No, this is a revolution. We can't... Look out, that's minus 50 of manpower just to strike home what you're actually doing. We can't, like, in the middle of the revolution, I think that to step down like that or to, like, compromise is probably as horrible as it is. Probably not the best idea. Because it does not play well with the quote-unquote domestic audience here. So their wealth and lives are ours. Yeah, so the Red Guard is not doing too well against the US Army. I'll halt their assault for now, try to just hold instead. I'm taking that one piece of territory there because of the river here still allows us a pretty favorable front line. As we got another militia army, this one is the Pennsylvania militia. They will be led by, I suppose, Milton Wolf. Yep, I spelled Pennsylvania correctly. These ones will be a strange color of green, I think. No, because they're going to be operating next to the militia, so I'm going to make them orange. Or whatever color that is. They're going to be operating next to the reserves. And then I'll reorient the reserves down south to hold this. And these guys are revolutionary garrison, so I'll put them in the reserves. In fact, I can actually put these guys in the Illinois militia, I think. And the Spanish Civil War has also erupted, as it did in history, though slightly different here. There is no Francisco Franco on the sort of right-wing amalgamation of fascist and monarchist groups. CNTFAI declared war on the Kingdom of Spain. And the 1936 Dutch elections. Taking advantage of the opportunity available to them to eradicate the far right, the Social Democratic SDAP has joined in coalition with the Socialist RSAP. So now they have Social Democrats. The Dutch do love their elections. And Sweden has joined the Reichspact. Reichspact, I gotta say. Because every time I say it, I accidentally say the Reichspact. We've got the volunteers from the Commune in France and from the Union of Britain have arrived. See, let's rush for Boston and try to take the victory points up here. Possibly take all of the ports as well, so this becomes a quicker encirclement. This is really bad. Okay, the militia has started to reach the line, which means I can send these guys over here to hold there. Our immediate focus right now. Oh, Queen Wilhelmina abdicates the Dutch throne. That song lag was a bit weird. In an astonishing sequence of events by Dutch standards, Queen Wilhelmina has abdicated the throne after a half a century of rule. Dismayed by the victory of the Left Links electoral pact, Wilhelmina had boldly stated that she would only accept the moderate VDE's candidate as formateur. Peter Oid, as formateur Peter Oid, I don't know what that means, despite the SDAP's victory, forcing them instead to ally with the socialist RSAP, with even moderate parliamentarians furious at her inadvertently forcing the SDAP to the left. Queen Wilhelmina's position quickly became untenable, and the SDAP's Willem Albarda was appointed. So she's abdicated because she refused to appoint the new sort of prime minister, which is what you often do in constitutional monarchies. The government is formed, and then the monarch must confirm the government, as happens in Norway every election. And sometimes, in history, the monarch, I believe, has refused to confirm a government. And, I mean, he did so as well, I believe, with the government of Vidkun Quisling. Strictly because he, you know, refused to surrender. When Norway was invaded by Nazi Germany. And democracy prevails in the Philippines. That's cool. So they are no longer under the United States, of course, because they broke free during the... Like how this, like, half of... I don't even know what this is. Is this Long Island? I don't know. Isn't this Long Island? No. This is Rhode Island, isn't it? Dude, I don't know. One of these is Long Island, one of these is Rhode Island. I don't know. Maybe it's the other way around. I thought Rhode Island was in Massachusetts, and... Dude, I don't know. But either way, this long piece of thing here. Half of it is held by Douglas MacArthur, and half of it is held by our syndicalist brothers in arms. Called Brothers and Sisters. A lot of the fighting here seems to be very, like, inefficient. The troops aren't really focusing on taking, like, key territory. Like, taking this, for example, they can't take this once we've taken it, so we can just take this and then leave it.
Orders. In every
hand. Now, we hold, let's see. Oh yeah, we hold exactly 14 tiles here, which is good. That's all we need. Don't like that line there. I don't want to push west because there's really nothing for us west. We gotta take the east and then hold the east and then push south. Because if we do that, we can take all of the like important industrial areas and stuff, and the larger population centers, possibly recruit more militias, and then once we've sort of entrenched ourselves on the eastern seaboard, we can start thinking of pushing west. That is the larger strategy I would like to employ. We don't actually hold the port here, so we want to take Providence, Rhode Island, or whatever. Providence, sorry. Providence, Rhode Island, isn't that? No. Is Providence on Rhode Island? I don't know. I keep, that keeps popping into my head for some reason. Oh, they actually did push through here. I'm gonna collapse this so that we are holding a smaller line. Bulges like these cause us to hold a longer line. Female soldiers, with the revolutionary struggle continue. Whilst the revolutionary struggle continues, a number of women have joined. It's a comma there. Have joined the armed struggle in accordance with the socialist ideals of gender equality. While not all are accepted by their male comrades, it has not deterred many from fighting and dying for the revolution. Manuals have been distributed to recruiters on how to effectively organize women detachments, of which the militias can teach the military a thing or two. 10,000 extra manpower. Do we get the... no, we don't get the women, like, women in the military national idea yet, which gives plus 3% manpower. Holy fuck, this goes hard. Resistance rises in Midwest. Okay, these are ESA resistances. Support for the Democratic proponents of the Pacific government has been strong in the American Midwest. Can't even speak. Sorry, this is the first episode I'm recording today, so I'm kind of tired. Especially considering the indulgence in the Norwegian pastime last night. These protests have recently become more organized and have culminated in a widespread uprising across Colorado, quietly funded and equipped through underground means. Whether these rebels will succeed in opening up a new front or for the Civil War remains to be seen. A nuisance at best. Yeah, so this with the AI is probably not going to be very helpful, but for the player that's really cool. Because you can then start to like try to cut off the supplies of the Big Mac's troops. Our convoys are getting shot down by submarines. We don't actually have the destroyers because I chose the cruisers instead. So we're making destroyers, but that's going to take a while. We can't really stop those. Carlist Spain has declared war on the CNT FAI. So there you go, three-way civil war. With Javier I, Falange Española, Alfonso the 13th of Bourbon, and the Central Committee. Spain will be torn to shreds as a battlefield for the ideological forces of the wider world. Hope you boys give some support to CNT FAI so, you know, they don't become a nuisance, a thorn in your back, Communist France, whenever you go to war with Germany. As they sometimes can be. If they fall to the monarchists, or if the monarchists remain in power in Spain, that can be very hard for the AI to manage. Oops. Yeah, I should be on the 1.7 version, so I could do this. Can I? No, I can't. What? I thought for sure I was on 1.7. I should be able to drag this, and then this one should be dragged as well. That's annoying. Militia in New York City. I completely forgot about that. Apologies. Okay, the those are the Italian or the French? Those are the French volunteers. They're just holding New York and doing literally nothing. Luckily, we have other French and Union volunteers fighting over here by Philadelphia. Fucking Russian volunteers as well. The Mozambique Bush War. Middle Africa declared war on Portugal. Oh boy. This is a limited war, which means it doesn't pull in the Entente or anything if Portugal aligns itself with the Entente. I don't think, at least. Though, potentially, it could, I suppose. If the, because the mod makers do want flashpoints, and that could be a good flashpoint for, you know, things to go tits up. That's the official political science term for it. Could have just encircled this dude because he's overextending really hard. Yeah, we actually haven't even done anything with air wings. I didn't even know we had any, and they, like, they spawned them for us. I thought we wouldn't have any at all. Let's yeah, how many do they have here? Way too many. We can't go there. That's probably like two different enemies as well. Let's send them to. Oh, we don't even need them in New England. Let's send them to the west here. Oh fuck! I clicked that off before I could even read it. I'm sorry. Terribly sorry. Let's go here. Well, the steel belt and not the rust belt here. Medium bomb. What are you called? Medium bomber. Yeah. Douglas B-18 Bolo. Let's have them here and have the larger one, I think, maybe do some strategic bombers bombing in Appalachia or Appalachia or whatever, however you pronounce that. What the fuck? I heard a recruitment there. Or not. Ready. Yes, sir. Move out. I'm right, control right clicking here to have them help out, like basically attack the tile or the troop in the tile without actually attacking the right, without actually moving into the tile itself. Bourgeoisie flee to Canada. The bourgeoisie have decided they will flee to flee the CSA. Thousands have sought refuge within enemy territory, especially within the illegitimate Canadian government. The thieving scum have taken whatever their stolen whatever of their stolen wealth they could carry with them, as they've escaped the revolution. Unfortunate, that's a lot of lost political power as well. That probably doesn't happen if we do the one where we don't kill them. You know? The Revolutionary Education Act. To those who are well educated, either formally or through bitter experience, revolutionary thought comes as easily as breathing. However, many of our comrades, whether in the Steel Belt or elsewhere in America, have been lied to their entire lives by the capitalists. Very typical of these kinds of movements, where all education is indoctrination. Which technically it is. By definition, education is indoctrination, but indoctrination in order to, you know, function in a group, I suppose. and do not understand how the revolution frees them. Many do not give their heart and soul to the revolution, and many even attempt to sabotage our efforts, unaware that we are the only force that truly cares for them. This must be remedied, and our comrades must be deprogrammed. Should we focus on reaching those in our territory, keeping our own morale up, or should we spread our message throughout enemy territory and sap their will to fight their liberators? So we can focus on the socialist family or focus on the reactionary enemy. So it's stability or war support. We have enough war support. Let us focus on the socialist family. And let us just push hard here to take Bangor and the rest of the territory here so that we can move out of this area. Right, we have reached the end point of this episode, which means I need to check the casualties of this war. It's a lot of war here, Canadian-Panamanian war. Or Panamanian, sorry. But yeah, well, let's check the so I hate how it's all split, but let's check the war between the CSA and the United States, if we can even find it. Apparently we can't. God, I hate how the casualty sort of breakup of, or the casualty breakdown rather of the American Civil War doesn't work. Well, I guess we won't be doing that then. We can have a look at this though. 94,000, 58,000 for the Vietnam War of this era. We'll have a look at some of these other wars later in when they get deeper into the actual war. Serbia and Romania here. Yeah, that is it for this episode. Thank you so much for watching. If you would like, you can reach me on social media following the links in the description down below. My Twitter is good for sending me memes personally, or personally contacting me, or by getting or staying in the know, up to date about what's going on with the series. And the Discord is great for discussion, for the sharing of memes in a public forum, and you know, talking to and getting to know the community. If you join, please leave a message in the welcome section so I can approve you for shitposting. Basically, if you just join immediately, you can't post, you know, pictures and stuff, because I think you could potentially have a problem where people join en masse and post garbage. Anyways, that is it for the social stuff. If you would like to, you can also support me on Patreon, though of course it is entirely unnecessary. So long as you watch these videos, that is plenty enough support for me. And oh god, stop this. And yeah, it's only one tier, it's $1 and up. You can give however much you want or however little you want. It's all good. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Goodbye.